SMB Connect, India's largest integrated solution platform which connects SMEs and entrepreneurs across the nation. Despite several government initiatives and programs, Indian entrepreneurs and SMEs are still facing many challenges. Our mission is to help them overcome those by acting as a catalyst in propelling business growth, promoting innovation, technological advancement and digitalization, and making them successful global players. We have devised 5 pillars to stimulate productivity and growth of SMEs. Start, Manage, Expand series, annual knowledge event series organized concurrently in different cities of India, Advaita, to recognize and celebrate women entrepreneurs of India. Accelerate, entrepreneur awards to honor excellent and accelerating businesses. Listing services, provide a platform to expand digital footprint and customer outreach. Advisory services, help SMEs deal with industry-specific challenges and accelerate growth. Nationally recognized and well-acclaimed in India, SMB Connect is an industry pioneer that supports SMEs. By providing strategic and innovative end-to-end solutions, together let's help small businesses overcome all odds and succeed, because small can be big.
Good afternoon, everybody. This is Sandeep Andre. I am from SMB Connect, and I would like to welcome all of you for this particular webinar, which is part of our Start, Manage, Expand series webinar, the fourth in the series started during the lockdown, as we started the lockdown from April onwards. And during this four webinars, we have covered a lot of topics, right from the MSME packages, which was announced last week, about managing HR, managing businesses during the lockdown period, what are the strategies and policies which you want to plan during for this lockdown. And going forward, this particular session is talk as the business is opening up, government is helping, is allowing people to start their businesses. We thought it is an apt topic to talk about how to reboot our business after nearly around 60 days of lockdown. Before that, I just thought if you have gone through the address of our Prime Minister, he was talking about more of Atmanirbharta, talking more about local products. We at SMB Connect thought, why don't we create a platform where businesses can list their product and we can make it vocal and make it ensure that it goes to different parts of the world. So a local product being vocal is what we are trying to work it out. So this is the website, localandvocal.online. So if you go to the website, you can basically list your products and services. It's a very small step to list your product. You just have to put your name, email ID, and password, create an account, and list your products and services here. There are different categories are available which you can list, so that people who are coming and identifying and finding any looking for any product and services, they can reach you, from advertising material to agro products to Ayurvedic, cycle rickshaws, computers and softwares, design process, processing custom made products, exhibitions and fairs, foods and beverages, gems and jewelry, handicrafts, home supplies. The list is quite exhaustive, and you can definitely add your products and services in this, so that people from different parts of the globe can come and reach this initiative from SMB Connect to help businesses to reach out a larger share of market. That was about this particular thing. So let me introduce to our speaker for the day, Mr. Ajay Shath. Ajay is a good friend of mine, and we've been there for the last 7 years or so. Been known to me as a very great business person, a mentor and coach. He is also a turnaround specialist. Last I heard, turnaround 3 to 4 different organizations. Zydus Pharma, Zydus Hospital is one organization which has worked last and has turned around that. Has worked with various pharmaceutical companies, and currently as the president of Windlabs Biotech, he is overseeing their business in Dehradun. So over to you, Ajay, to take this session. I am sure people will be enjoying this.
Thank you very much, Sandeepan, for your kind words. And let me also welcome all the participants who are here. Most of us here in this room are now small and medium enterprises. I know some of them are professionals, and I also know that some of them are students. Looking at all of you, I must say that there is something in it for each one of you, whether you are a student or a professional or a SME owner. So have a little bit of an open mind, particularly to students who are here. I would like to say that think that this is how the owner would like you to behave. This is how the real world is. So be very open and enjoy this small session. Here, what I'm going to take you through is the, you know, kind of what exactly should we be doing since we are now opening after so many days. So just like we have closed our computer for some days and that computer has to restart, inside the computer there are two things that run simultaneously. One of them is reboot command runs a diagnostic for hardware as well as the software. So similarly, in our businesses, we have to reboot, run a diagnostic for our hardware and the software. In the case of businesses, the hardware is the men, machine, and money. The software is the orders, systems, and processes. So we have to take time to dust the hardware. You see, we have to take stock and motivate people. Many of them have stayed in their homes. People get anxious. Some of them may not have got their salary. Some of them have got less salary. Some of them have not been able to earn any money. They are your daily rated workers. So people would be in a state of anxiety. So first thing that we do as soon as we restart is connect with our people, motivate our people. And the second is dust and oil the machines, which means all the machinery needs to be in place. For example, now when the airlines are going to restart, they will not be able to restart with 100% of the planes. They will restart with about 30%, and slowly they will add more and more planes to their, you know, flying. And the third is the understanding the cash flow. You see, if you are closed down for 60 days, any business which is closed down for 60 days knows that one of the worst things to happen is a liquidity crunch. Everybody who has to take money from you is always ready, but people who have to pay will find excuses not to pay. So it is very important to keep wheels of the business running. So important for you to analyze what is the cash flow situation of the company. So coming to the software of the businesses at the restarting time, the first and foremost is review the order position. You see, every business runs on orders and execution. So first priority should be to those orders where your payments will come first of all. The only thing that you need help right now, apart from the government steps to give you liquidity, I think the thing that will ultimately be responsible for your running of the business is going to be payments coming in through orders being executed. But while orders are being executed, there are a lot of things, a lot of money will be stuck in GST refund, in GST credit, in payment from big corporates. Immediately put your people and get that money into the system, because that will give you quick liquidity and that will give a good kickstart to the business. The second is rework systems in view of the supply chain disruption and fill in the gaps. You see, what happens is that sometimes, for example, in a pharma company, there could be a disruption in printing material. There could be a disruption in this raw material. There could be a disruption in excipients. So each problem has to be identified, and people have to be encouraged to work in project mode, and identified bottlenecks have to be completed with deadlines. If everything moves as per a schedule, like a harmony, only then the end product will come out as smoothly as it is possible. And the third is involve. You see, involve as many people to put the best processes in place. What will happen is, when you restart, many of the people will not like to come to the office. Many of the people will not be able to come to the office. Some will not want to come to the office. Some cannot come to the office. So obviously, we have to learn to operate with lower numbers. In one case, I can say with great confidence, one of the companies gave the highest maximum throughput in the month of April. It was pharma was running with only 60% of the manpower. So if 60% could give the highest sales, then imagine how much 100% can give. There are certain changes which are taking up in the environment. Now, these environmental assessments have to be done very carefully. There will be many impacts for micro companies. If you look at the micro environment, there will be many changes. You know, there will be problems with labor, there will be problems with, you know, material coming in, problem with the truckers, problem with loading, unloading. There will be all kinds of problems. But I am just thinking that for every company in India today, whether we are in domestic or in exports, there are three long-term implications. And these three long-term implications have impact on each company in small measure or big measure. But each of these three will have impact on everybody. What I request you all is to see these three broad trends as indicators and see the way we have analyzed. Because the way we have analyzed is a generic method where these observations are valid for everybody. So, for example, if we see there is a crash down in the petroleum price because every economy is not using that much energy. Since energy is not used, petroleum prices have gone down. All pipelines are full. Petrol pumps are full. Refineries are full. Ship loads are waiting outside the ports to unload. There is no way to pick up that material. So prices are going down. In fact, I don't know, many of you may not know, but there was a time for about 1 hour when refineries were giving money to just pick up their material. So they were giving $36 per barrel just to remove the material, because otherwise the refinery will be closed. So we have gone through that kind of a situation. The refineries have almost come to a standstill. The second is China has been blamed, whether we like it or not, but China has taken a lot of blame for this corona, and China has lost a lot of credibility. As a result, that is a very important trend, and it will have an impact on every company. The third trend is, across the world, people will try to save money. There will be more savings. There will be less expenditure. As a result, economies will be shrinking. Earnings will be going down. So we have to be alert on these three major implications on every SME. Let me say that petroleum. Look at petroleum. Petroleum prices goes down. It means a lot of chemical industries use petroleum downstream products as feedstock. So their prices have gone down. If the feedstock prices have gone down, it will have an impact on the lower feedstock, on the lower downstream products as well. For example, if benzene, for example, price goes down, all derivatives of benzene prices will come down later. Maybe 1 month, maybe 2 months, prices will definitely come down. So how it impacts you? As SME, you should try not to be fooled into people telling you, ki sab aaj ye mil raha hai, fatafat le lo, kal ko milega nahi. Fact is that there is a lot of oversupply and prices are going to go down. So all SMEs at this point of time should maintain as low inventory as possible. This will help them to get rid of or to save themselves from speculative losses on price of inventory. Energy. When petroleum prices have gone down, our bill for energy will definitely go down. So there can be a tendency that we become a little more complacent and we start using energy recklessly. That's not the case. See, petroleum prices today have gone down, but it will not remain down for all times to come. Petroleum prices are cyclical, they'll come back. So don't spoil your habits by wasting energy. Continue your efforts for energy conservation as usual. Coming to China. You see, China has had a lower trust. As a result of this lower trust, whether we like it or not, China will definitely lose trust. Loss of trust will give an opportunity to several industries, whether in domestic or in exports. For example, some of the people in India, they are importing the Chinese material. Their prices will definitely go down over a period of time. The other thing is, China is also your competitor. China is your biggest competitor, not only in India. China is also a very big competitor globally. And your biggest competitor is today weak. I was listening to a very senior businessman, and he said that just because of Corona, they have enhanced their target for 2021 from the 8% that they had planned to this year, they are planning 100% growth. And I'm talking of a domestic company, very large company. This is the biggest company. They said that because there is going to be a disruption from China, we foresee 100% growth. So this is in the domestic market. So when there is disruption from China, it's an opportunity, and encash it as well as you can. Other thing is, China is very strong in West Europe and USA. So anybody who has not been to USA or Europe to export, you must look at these two markets very seriously. Because if you do, then a lot of opportunities will come up for you, because many companies, I know of several chemical and pharmaceutical companies, they are looking to shift their sourcing, their supply chain from China to, they will either shift to Japan or to Taiwan or to India, but there will be a very big shift. And imagine that China has so much of production that if we get just 10% of that share, Indian economy will actually become double. Another thing that is going to happen is that there will be a loss of, you know, economies will be shrinking, there will be a loss of earnings. So that is going to be a major trend. But some industries like pharma, they will sustain, because every patient needs medicine. Although even in pharma, there are some segments, for example, antibiotics, the sale has gone down. But anti-anxiety, the sale has gone up. So there will be some shrinkage of earnings in all economies and across sectors also. But some people like pharma, they will sustain. Non-essential like holidays, you know, anything connected to hospitality, whether it is restaurants or hotels, or it is taxi operators, all of them will have a problem this year because everybody is trying to save money. The second thing is, you see, whenever something is sustaining, anything which is sustaining like pharma also, there will be some unforeseen competition as well. For example, I am just giving an example of pharma. In the case of pharma, many manufacturers will start thinking that why not we back integrate and go into chemical. Simultaneously, many chemical manufacturers will start thinking that why don't we forward integrate and go into pharma. But if somebody back integrates or goes forward integration, they will be losing very precious time. And in that time, all those people who collaborate rather than create. You see, a pharma company and a chemical company, they can collaborate. So one can become the other supplier and they can work mutually beneficially. So they will be in a better position because they have collaborated and they have made a better speed. And speed is of essence because time is going to change very fast and it's not going to wait for anybody. Similarly, just imagine, you see, last 2 months, we have not been able to go to saloons and spas in the last 2 months. As a result, what has happened is, most of the service providers have found ways. It is India. We are a Jugadu company, country. So many of the people who were giving services, whether it is barbers or it is, you know, therapists, they have found ways to approach and reach home. So what has happened is, saloons and spas, they have created a new kind of competition. Earlier, these therapists, these barbers were not going home. Now they will be going home. As a result, a new category of competition is going to come in. Similarly, restaurants, they are now allowed to deliver food. So a restaurant which was very swanky, which had a 100-seater place, is now competing with a one-person-based home delivery system. So there, a new kind of competition is going to come in. So we have to be alert for that also. While this is happening, there will be some opportunities. You see, if you are sitting on cash, there will be opportunities because some of the people will get distressed, they'll want to move out, they're not with deep pockets. So if you have some cash floating around, this would be a good opportunity to shop around and look for good business to acquire. Now, while that is happening and we are opening up, another very important thing is we have to manage our workforce. You see, in order to manage the workforce, you cannot have one stick manages all. You see, we have to understand as businessmen that you have to survive first, which means you have to become more efficient by the day, which means lower salaries by the day, which means less number of people for the same output, which also means that if we have to deal with different qualities of people differently, then we have to segment our workforce. So I am trying to give you a very rough number, which says that every company will have assets and liabilities in manforce, in manpower. Some people are genuinely assets. They are giving more to the company than they are receiving from the company. There are some who are liabilities. They get more than they give back to the company. So we have to identify the assets and liabilities among the workforce. So we have to create four segments of workforce and create a smart grid. This is a very, you know, easy thing to do. Anybody can do it. The grid that I'm going to give you is that this is the biggest opportunities for SMEs to work without emotions. You see, first thing is the SME has to survive. Only if he survives and he's efficient, only then one day he can do charity. But right now is not the time. Right now the time is to survive yourself first. First of all, take care of yourself. First of all, take care of your business. Only then start thinking about welfare. You see, these are very lofty things to say, but on ground, these are very difficult to implement. For example, some people will leave. You see, some people are very finicky. They'll say, no, mere ko nahi aana ji, mere ko to jaan ko bada khatra lag raha hai. And they will say, main kal se nahi aana chahta. Okay, thank you. If you don't want to come, thank you. No problem. Then don't take replacement for left or sacked employees without capability and willingness to work. Many of the people, they didn't want to work. So they were looking for an excuse and they went. Some of them, they wanted to work, but they didn't have the capability. If they want to leave, by all means, let them also go. Now, this is the grid I want all of you to see very carefully. You see, on the top line, you have two columns. One is, this person has capability. The other is, this person does not have capability. And on the left hand side, you have one column which has two rows, where we have one person who is willing worker and the other person is unwilling worker. Which means now you have four types of people. One is who has capability and who has willingness. So he's in absolute green. You would like to retain him. The other person is capability, no, but willingness, yes. So he is a good candidate for hand holding and for training. And once you have handheld him and you have trained him, he will now become a good person, good resource. He has capability as well as us. But coming to the third quarter, you see, here is a person who has capability but does not want to work. He will find an excuse. I don't want to work. I don't want to work. I have capability, but I don't want to work. And the fourth is he didn't have capability as well as he's not willing to work. Now, in these four categories, how do we handle that? The first is has capability and is willing. So in this case, we retain them even at a higher cost. In fact, we must reward them. You would have noticed his concern for your business. He would have risked his health for your business during Corona. So in this case, this person deserves your reward. So it may not be right now, but remember his attitude and reward him for his commitment at the first opportunity. He is a good person. You must try to retain him. The second is, here is a person who has willingness. He's willing to work. He was always coming, whatever lockdown or whatever, he tried his level best. He came. But sometimes he didn't know how to perform. And he was always saying, "Sab mujhe batao kya karu." So here is a person who doesn't have capability but is willing. So what you can do is put him through some performance improvement program, give him some time, okay, 3 months, train him, and in 3 months he would have learned his thing and he would now become an asset. The way this person should be allowed to become a liability. He has willingness, he should come. Now coming to the third person. This person has capability but is not willing to work. So what we normally do, we counsel them. In HR language we say, okay, we will counsel. And if he agrees, if he understands that these are difficult times and you have to work, otherwise you will be fired. So if he does come up, then you know, you have to be a little stern with them. If he accepts, then good. He's become now an asset. If he does not accept, then you have to let him go. You cannot do charity. Coming to the fourth person. This person didn't have capability and also was not willing. But you were just carrying him because chalta hai, business chalta hai. Now is the time you should fire without feeling guilty, because now it is a question of your own survival. So fire without feeling guilty. Just tell them, okay, thank you very much. This is not the time. We have to fire. We have to survive ourselves first. And if you have to survive, then you have to leave. And we cannot have, you know, load carrying. We are not a load carrying company. You have to run for yourself. You have to carry your own load. So in this case, you have to part at first opportunity. Thanks and good riddance. Now I come to, you see, if you generally are comfortable with whatever is seen, then you would also notice that while we are undertaking these four kind of strategies, four kind of people we are handling, but you have to convey some message to the whole company. See, we have to do a proper public relations in the whole company. So what we convey to our team members? We have to convey them very uprightly, very honestly, that Corona times are tough times and only the best will last. The bad people, the inefficient people, they will just die out. Nobody can save them. Then you should also convey that we are forced to implement extensive cost cutting and efficiency at all levels, whether it means cutting salaries or it means not giving incentives or it means not giving, you know, promotions, whatever it is, you have to convey and people will normally accept. Everybody knows, everybody is genuinely anxious whether they will survive or not, whether the job will remain or not. So in this situation, in case you are able to tell them, that we have to do that, we are forced to do this, people will readily accept. You should also tell them that we will be fair and we will follow our labor laws, we will not go on any commitment, but these are tough times and those who want to leave, in case you are not comfortable, by all means leave. But this is part of the PR. As the PR, this message should go very loud and clear, because if you make a mistake here, then it can snowball into labor disputes or whatever. Now coming to one important aspect, which is, you see, when you're really opening, then some risk will definitely be there. Some risk will be there when you're reopening the business. Now, what kind of risk we have and what kind of tangible strategies we can take and how can we mitigate that risk? So there are certain things which are known to everybody. And one of the things is that everybody knows the rules of hygiene and social distancing. No need to repeat in this webinar. But everybody knows, follow those hygiene and social distancing rules very fastidiously, because Corona will be unforgiving. Once you get it in a factory, in Himachal, we know two pharma factories had to close down because of, you know, Corona. It spread and it spread so quickly that nobody was able to stop it. Then encourage your employees to declare medical conditions without fear. You see, some employees will just be afraid ki mera paisa na kat jaye. Some people will not like to tell you, sir, I'm sick. So how do you handle that? You have to give them confidence. And in case you are sick, don't worry. Tell us honestly, quarantine yourself at home, and we will still continue to pay your salary. You see, by paying salary to 2-3 people, you will be able to run your factory. But if those 2-3 people don't have confidence on you that you will continue to pay the salary, they can, you know, they can possibly come back and say, ke sahab, main to paise ke chakkar mein office aa gaya, and chuki office aa gaya, so now there's no way. So how do you handle that? You have to give them confidence that, okay, declare your condition, don't worry, we are there to support. The third is, insist on download of Arogya Setu app in all phones of not only all employees, but also the people in the family. Also tell them to get this downloaded in the maid's phone, in the driver's phone, anybody that they are coming in contact with. That will be good, because then it becomes a very early warning system. The next thing is, invest in smart insurance. You see, there are many insurance products that SMEs are usually not very up to date on. So call some people, especially on general insurance. There are insurance policies which can cover risk of business disruption and losses. So take those little insurance. It will safeguard in case, God forbid, if Corona spreads in a factory and you are forced to close down for a month, then you can monetize and say that I lost so much money, and you can recover that money from insurance. There are such products available. The third and the last important thing is invest in group medical insurance. You see, group medical insurance is far cheaper than individual medical insurance. So if you take a group medical insurance, not only for your employee, but also for the families, A, it becomes a very good gesture on your part. And also, the employee feels more confident, he would like to remain. Employee retention becomes much easier. So my suggestion is, invest in group medical insurance, not just to take care of the employees, but also to ensure longevity of your employees in the company. Now, to sum up, I would just like to recap. You see, what we have done in this session is that we have said that when you are rebooting, there will be certain, you know, things that you have to do. First is check men, machine and money, review your orders, rework your systems and involve your team. Secondly, diligently scan the environmental changes, as we said, for petroleum, China, or, you know, reducing expenditure. So diligently scan environmental changes that impact your business. Also, identify the assets and liabilities in your team, make a smart grid. And when you are taking a decision, take those decisions without emotions. You have to be selfish at this time. The business has to run, and if the business has to run, you have to be more efficient. Only an efficient system, only an efficient company, lower expenses, higher profits, only that kind of a company will survive the long run. And finally, take adequate medical and smart insurance benefit from Arogya Setu app, follow health guidelines. And I may also add here, you see, SMEs are today being seen by the government as the backbone of Indian economy. There is a lot of money. The government is not giving money directly to anybody who is sitting at home. So they are giving money in indirect ways so that people have money to spend. So if they spend money, there will be some demand in the market. Also, there will be some credit which will come to SMEs, whether it is as GST or as income tax benefit or as electricity fixed charge. Any benefit which is coming to SMEs, you must, you know, spend some time and take all those benefits. Those benefits, even if they're 5% of your expectation, still they will be important when you're dealing with your banks. Of course, banks will be, you know, postponing your interest, and there'll be some moratorium given on installments. So don't worry on that. Banks will be very cooperative, I can assure you. I'm not saying on behalf of the banks, I'm saying because I can see the direction of the government. And I think that I have tried to convey in brief all the practical things that I should have covered. And I hope that this webinar was worth your time that you spent with me. Stay safe. And in case you want to connect with me, I'm there on LinkedIn. You can connect me through SME Connect. You see, many a times, Sandeepan has come to me for some help for some of the SME participants who have been with him. And we are very happy to help, whether it is, on business development or it is on organization development. Whatever is your challenge, do find time to connect with Sandeepan. And Sandeepan is a very good resource, very sincere person. I've been working for, for his seminars for about 10 years now, and it is always a pleasure. So wish you all stay safe. Wish you all a very happy life, happy opening, happy rebooting. God bless you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ajay. I think we have some questions. I will share the questions right now so that you can address them. People have a lot of questions on that. And I think it was very wonderful, and I really like the analogy of rebooting a machine and the rebooting the business. That particular analogy is, the analogy is really, really appreciated. And I think it actually connects very well, because when you start again after 60 days layoff or lockdown, you would definitely need to look at both the things. So let me straight away go to first question from Mr. Devinder Singh. Though I think it was predominantly answered during your session, but still ask this question. He's asking, Ajay, biggest pain is salary. Can work with half the staff as of today. we are into telecom services, but will it be favorable to continue with full strength? Please suggest.
You see, my answer remains what I've already said. You see, if you look at your 100% strength, your assets as manpower will definitely be around 50%. So in case you really are able to identify and motivate your balance 50% over the assets, and you can get them on board, I think that the liability part, you should actually find an opportunity to shed that fat at this point and try and get rid of some people, I would say, and try to work with as less people as you can. The only thing is that you have to learn motivation and you have to learn connecting with people once again. It will be a challenge. I do realize that. But in case you can find ways to keep connected, convey your seriousness and your, you know, honesty, and you can work with transparency, you are sure that 50 to 60% of your staff, even in DISCOMs, will be able to sustain this.
Okay, so next question. So next question I have is from Pulkit Rauturi. His question is, what is your opinion to deal with investors during the time of post-corona? And also, you want to know your opinion about whether to import or totally denounce import-export from China. So those are two questions from Pulkit Rauturi.
Okay. I am not clear about the first question. He used the word, what is that? He used the word.
What is your opinion? How to deal with investors during this time or the post-corona time?
Okay, investors. Okay, okay, got it. Investors. You see, I don't know, Mr. Ruturi, I don't know whether you are an investor yourself or you are looking for investors. Let me tell you that at this point of time, every investor is very bullish. Investors want to come in. When people are trying to go out, this is the time when investors will come in. So in case you're an investor, be aggressive, go out and, you know, seek out your target. And in case you're looking for investors, be very open. A lot of investors are looking for you. So as far as investors go, I'm very bullish. I think investors are today putting in money. They are not running away. And it's like, you know, just imagine that if suppose it is a bad time, people are leaving. So then it means that people will be able to buy assets at lower cost. It is an investor's dream, you know. Investors want this kind of time to come every year. But that doesn't come in, unfortunately. Now, so investors are willing to invest. And in case you are looking to invest, again, same. You see, if you are looking to invest, go ahead, make investments. It's a good time to invest. Don't worry. This economy will bounce back, and it will bounce back much better than before, I can assure you. Don't worry. The second question that you asked was about should we ban all imports from China? Let me say, there is a lot of rhetoric in the market. There is Swadeshi Jagran Manch, there are others who are saying the China ko ban karo, boycott karo, all those things will continue in the market. But let me tell you very honestly, this is a globalized economy. No economy can survive in isolation. Not USA, not Germany, not India, not Japan, not China. Nobody can survive in isolation. So whatever people will try and do and say, there will be imports and exports from China. There is no doubt, nothing can stop it. But I can tell you one example, and that example you should remember. You see, Japan has not banned any import from USA. Since Second World War, Japan did not ban any import from USA. But Japanese people felt so hurt because of Hiroshima and Nagasaki that till date, no American product is sold in Japan. You cannot find a, you know, Ford car sold in Japan. No product from America is sold in Japan. Although there is no restriction, there is no extra duty on that. People will just not buy it. So that sentiment, I expect, that sentiment will be there in India also. Many Indians will stop buying Chinese products. That I can say it off the cuff. You see, and I'm sure many of you must have noticed, now, if you are looking at a Chinese product, whether it is a Xiaomi or it is, you know, a Lava or whatever, questions do come to our mind, and sometimes you decide. Crackers, for example, there were low sale last year because we were not happy with what they did in Doklam. So that kind of a macro impact will definitely come. Imports from China will definitely go down. And if you are an importer from China, then you must look at alternatives. But at the same time, there will be some areas where import will continue and nobody can stop. Yes.
Okay, next question is from Vedant Patel. Yeah, thanks, Ajay. So let me see the next. Okay, the next question is Vedant. Vedant is asking about this local and vocal services which we have from SMB Connect have started. So this is Vedant is what we're planning is provide a platform for businesses to list their products which are locally manufactured. And we at SMB Connect through our platform, through our digital initiatives, can promote and promote these services across different platform. We are connected with both multiple associations, be it internal Indian and from outside India. We organize various conferences and seminars where networking can happen. In fact, today morning we had a session with the Indo-American Indo-Latin American the Chamber of Commerce, and there's a lot of opportunities for businesses to go and start exporting in that particular geography. So this particular initiative is predominantly to create a platform and ensure that most of the businesses or small businesses, if you have to say particularly, who are not there in the digital space, helping them out to be on the digital space, and then we can promote it. So this particular listing is right now free of cost for any businesses. So they can just come in, list their product and services, and we can and then they can promote it in our different social media platform. The website is localandvocal.online. So if you can just write down, I have also shared that on the chat to all of you, so you can have it in your inbox there. Okay, so there's another question from Jayant Dabbag Guttu. Difficult to pronounce, so please pardon me if I got it wrong. So Ajay, the question is there any benefit given by government for startups during pandemic 2020? For anything for
the startup? Let me just answer that for you. You see, the government has earmarked a lot of funds and they are giving up to a crore of rupees as collateral free loan for startups. You can go on the SME government of, you know, MSME website of the government. And not only is there something from central government, but also state governments are doing a lot of effort. So you must look at that. And I would suggest that you get in touch with some local chartered accountant, because chartered accountants and bankers, they will be the first to decode that, whatever is the facility for you. In case you are not able to decode from the MSME website, you can just consult somebody and you can find out depending upon your work. For example, there is a micro loan available up to 1 lakh rupees at 2% in Uttarakhand for people who are doing small businesses, you know, some vegetable seller or, you know, very, very small businesses. Government has offered 1 lakh rupees loan without collateral at 2% annual interest. Of course, it will be returnable. Not, you know, it is not a grant. It is not a money given as a favor. That money has to come back.
I just want to add on that. Next Friday, we are at SMB Connect is organizing a webinar, which is specifically discussing about the packages which has been announced by the finance minister for MSMEs and startups. So that is on next Friday. So please check our social media on be it LinkedIn or Facebook or Twitter, and you will get to know, you will have the update. So we will have a banker. We are looking at having somebody from SIDBI and State Bank of India, and most probably from the RBI. So these three people from three different banks will be there to decode the package, the schemes which has been announced by the FM finance minister and last week. So we will so please watch the space and follow us on the on the social media, and you will have some update on that. So that was the last question, I think, and I think we can wrap it up with this. So thank you all of you for joining this session. Thank you, Ajay, for sharing this interesting presentation with all of us. Thank
you, Sandeepan, and thank you, Rachana, for you know such a wonderful session. Thank you very much, everybody.
So this Ajay, with your permission, we can share this presentation as a video to all the place social media.
By all means.
Can have absolutely. Access to that.
No. Absolutely, by all thank means. You. By all means. I mean, this is your property. You take it. Do whatever you want to.
So thank you. Thank you. So nice of you. So Ajay. So thank you very much, gentlemen. So this webinar ends now.
Thank you very much.